All right, guys, let's make the festive bottle holder. So cool. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Tiffany Hansen. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make my festive bottle holder. This is great for gift giving, and anyone that is an adult that likes beverages for their Christmas present, but you want to have that personal touch, that handcrafted little bit that sets the gift over the top and makes it that much more personal, that much more special to the person receiving it. This is a really fast project that you are just going to love, and they will too. If at any point in this video you do like what you see, please push that thumbs up button. Also, if you haven't yet, subscribe to my channel and click the bell, and then click all. That way you get notified whenever I release a brand new video. I try to release a brand new video every single Friday, covering a wide range of so many different types of crochet projects. You are not going to want to miss out. I also do tips and tricks, fun giveaways. We have a lot of fun here on my channel. If you want a little bit more involvement, I have a membership program that you can absolutely check out. There's some really cool stuff there. And if you want behind the scenes action, like the prepping and what's going on, the vlogging style of everything behind the channel, check out my Instagram page. We have a lot of fun there too. There's just so much going on, and you're not gonna wanna miss out. All right, so the pattern for the festive bottle holder, you can find both the description section and the comment section below this video. All you have to do is click on that link, purchase the pattern, print it off, and be ready to crochet with me. Now, as usual, you do not need the pattern in order to make this item. I will have the step-by-step instructions on the screen for you to follow along with me and make this awesome festive bottle holder. It's just nice to have the pattern sometimes if you want something to follow along with, or if you want to make more than one and you don't want to watch the video over and over and over again, the pattern comes in handy. All right, once you are all ready to go, let's dive right into what materials I used to make this festive bottle holder. The materials that we are going to use to make the festive bottle holder will include a 100% cotton yarn that is a size 4 weight worsted medium Aran 10-12 ply or 8 WPI sized yarn. I'm using approximately 143 yards of yarn, 131 meters, 85 grams or 3 ounces of yarn to complete this project. I am using the entire skein. This whole skein is going to be used. Lily's Sugar and Cream, the super-sized ball, is the one that I am using. I have the color Summerfield here, but you can use whatever color that you want to use. The crochet hook that we will use is the H8 or 5mm crochet hook. You'll need a yarn needle or tapestry needle in order to weave in those ends. You'll want a pair of scissors. You're going to need a ruler or a measuring tape when it comes to the tassels, so we can cut the strips all within the same measurement. And optional is the stitch marker to help guide you from row to row, because we are working in rounds. I will have links to everything that you see here in both the description section and comment section below this video. So if you want to get your hands on any exact thing I have here, you can just click on that link, purchase it, and have it shipped directly to you, or utilize whatever you have on hand. When you are ready to begin, let's dive right into actually making our festive bottle holder. All right, so we begin with our yarn and our crochet hook. Start with a tail. It doesn't really matter how long it is because we are not weaving this end into the project. Create your slip knot, attach your crochet hook, and we are ready to go. All right, so to begin, we are working in rounds. You can either begin with the magic ring, which in that case, you would begin a little bit differently, or the chain two method or the chain four method, which you would slip stitch and form that circle. You can use any of those because they all facilitate working in a round. All right, if you have trouble or are curious about the magic ring, then you can check out this video that I created, which really simplifies how to do that. But for me, I am using the chain two method. So I start by chaining two, one, two. For round one, we will make 10 half double crochet stitches inside the first chain, or inside your magic ring, or inside the ring that you created with your chain four. All right, so 10 half double crochet stitches. One, two, three, four, 9 and 10. Great. All right, to close round one, we will find the very first half double crochet stitch that we made and slip stitch into that, the top of that stitch. So slip stitch, and that creates this really cute little circle and closes off round one. If you want to, you can even add your stitch marker here or not. That is totally optional, but you would put it in that last stitch space. All right, so to move on to row two or round two, we will chain one. For round two, we will work two half double crochet stitches in each stitch all the way around. That's also known as an increase half double crochet stitch by adding two stitches in the same stitch space. You will end round two with a total of 20 half double crochet stitches. So let's begin. In that same stitch we just slip stitched into to close round one, we will make one, two half double crochet stitches. Next stitch space, make one, two. Go ahead and continue on, and I will meet you at the end of round two to show you what we do next. Oh, I've made it to my last stitch, so I'm going to go ahead and remove my stitch marker. Work two half double crochet stitches in my last stitch. So this is 19 and 20. Perfect. And then replace that stitch marker in that 20th stitch or the last stitch. Slip stitch into the first stitch of round two, and that closes round two right there. Moving on to round three. So for round three, we will chain one. The repeat pattern for round three will be two half double crochet stitches in the first stitch space, and then one half double crochet stitch in the next stitch space. Another way this would be worded is increase half double crochet in the first stitch and one half double crochet in the next stitch. You will repeat this pattern all the way around for round three, ending round three with a total of 30 half double crochet stitches. It'll be two, then one, two, one, two, one. So here we go. In that same stitch we just slip stitched into, one, two, next stitch, one, and then one, two, and one. 28, 29, and then I'm going to remove my stitch marker so I can make my last stitch. 30, great. And then if you want, you can replace that stitch marker in that last half double crochet stitch there. We will then slip stitch into the top of the first half double crochet stitch to close round three. Beautiful. Look at that. All right, so for round four, we're going to start by chaining one. The repeat pattern for round four is going to be increase half double crochet in the first stitch and then make one half double crochet stitch in the next two stitch spaces. So one, one, and then repeat the pattern, two, one, one, two, one, one. Repeat this pattern all the way around for round four, ending round four with a total of 40 half double crochet stitches. Here we go. One, two, one, one. One, two, one, one. 37, 38, 39. Oh, I'm going to move my stitch marker and 40. Perfect. Okay, you can put your stitch marker back if you'd like. Okay, slip stitch into the top of that very first half double crochet stitch. We have just closed round four. Perfect. So this is what you should be looking at here. Round five, all we are doing is chaining one and making one half double crochet stitch in every stitch space all the way around. You should end round five with a total of 40 half double crochet stitches. One, two, three, 39, and moving this stitch marker out of the way so I can do 40. Perfect. Okay, so replacing that stitch marker into that last stitch space and then slip stitching into the top of the first half double crochet stitch to close round five. Now we've just finished the bottom of the bottle holder. Round five, you will start to see a bit of a curve upwards because we are going to start working the body portion of this bottle holder. This is where we start doing the pattern that looks so cool. So for round six, we are going to be doing the front post half double crochet, back post half double crochet stitch pattern that looks really neat. We will begin by chaining one. That same stitch we just slip stitched into right here, that is our first stitch. We're going to yarn over, enter into the side of that stitch, go behind it, and come out the other side of that stitch. So you're right behind it, pushing it forward. Yarn over and pull that yarn through. So it kind of looks like you're flossing behind that stitch. Then yarn over and pull through all three loops on your crochet hook. And that is your front post half double crochet stitch. Next will be your back post half double crochet stitch. So first identify the next half double crochet, yarn over, come through the back, and that's just between the two stitches. Push that half double crochet backwards and go through the other side between those two stitches. Yarn over, pull that yarn through, and that yarn should glide like it's flossing that stitch, but from the other direction. Then yarn over and pull through all three loops on your crochet hook, and that is a back post half double crochet stitch. Repeat this pattern, front post, back post, all the way around. You should end with this stitch marker, this half double crochet stitch should be a total of 40 stitches. So from here on out, every single round will have a total of 40 stitches in each round. That should help you to keep on track. So here we go, front post, half double crochet. And then back post, half double crochet. Front post, half double crochet, back post, half double crochet. Oh, move my stitch marker. Front post, half double crochet. Great. All right, and then replace my stitch marker and slip stitch into the top of that very first front post half double crochet stitch to close round six. There we go. And now we see that really cool post stitch pattern. Looks really neat. Okay, so for round seven, we will chain one. Nope, let's do it again, chain one, perfect. Now for round seven, we are just doing the opposite of what we did for round six. So if you see a front post half double crochet stitch, you will do a back post half double crochet stitch. So you'll come in from behind, push that stitch back, back post half double crochet. And then the next stitch is a back post half double crochet stitch. So I will make a front post half double crochet stitch. There we go. And then front post half double crochet stitch. So I will make a back post half double crochet stitch and repeat. All right, I think you've got the pattern. I will meet you at the end of round 7 to show you what to do next. This will be 39 and moving my stitch marker. Last stitch, 40. Great. Okay, so we have just finished round 7. Gonna slip stitch into the top of that first back post half double crochet stitch to close the round. There we go. Perfect. Now for round 8 through the end of round 25, you are just repeating round 6 and round 7, round 6 and round 7, because all you're going to do for each round is chain 1, look at the stitches from the row before, and do the opposite. And that's all you're going to have to focus on, really. So this is a back post half double crochet, so I'm going to work a front post half double crochet on that stitch. Next stitch is a front post half double crochet, so I will make a back post half double crochet stitch. And that's all you really need to focus on through the end of round 25, is looking at the round below and working the opposite stitch. And I will meet you at the end of round 25 to show you what we do next. You have got this. You're doing such a great job. Back post half double crochet, front post half double crochet, moving my stitch marker. All right, last stitch of round 25. Boom, right there. Replace my stitch marker and slip stitch into the first back post half double crochet stitch there to close round 25. Beautiful. All right, so now we're at the very top of this festive bottle holder. And what we're going to do is we are going to chain 1 and make 1 single crochet stitch in each stitch space all the way around. You should end round 26 with a total of 40 single crochet stitches. So let's go ahead and do that real quick, and I'll meet you at the end of round 26 to show you what to do next. And 40. Great. All right, so let's go ahead and slip stitch into the top of that first single crochet stitch to close round 26. Beautiful. Okay, so for round 27 through the end of round 34, all we are doing is chaining 1 and making 1 single crochet stitch in each stitch space all the way around. You should end each round, round 27 through round 34, with a total of 40 stitches in each round. All right, go ahead and continue on, and I will meet you at the end of round 34 to show you what to do next. All right, just finished round 34. Gonna slip stitch to close round 34. Now, once we are done with this section right here at the top, we're going to take our scissors and cut approximately a 15 inch long tail here. Approximate, doesn't have to be spot on. And then yarn over, pull the tail through the loop on our crochet hook, pull tight for a tie off. Perfect. Then take this top section of single crochets and fold it in half. I fold it towards the open on the outside, so it's like over this way. There we go, all the way around. Take your yarn needle or tapestry needle, thread that through. There we go. And then come over to this section, and you're going to go through the front and sew it to the back. And we are just going to sew this fold over so it's a nice thick cuff or thick top right here. Next stitch over, we're just gonna go and kind of weave it through. So in and out. All the way around. Awesome. And when we get to the end here, the very last one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come to the inside of the work, going to take that string, go around my thumb, insert my yarn needle back into the work, and just kind of pick up some stitches or pick up some yarn right here. Pull through, but my thumb is going to hold some of that yarn back. I'm going to take this loop that I've just created, and I'm going to go ahead and twist it. So if I'm looking at it like this, and I twist it, it forms this X shape right here. I'm going to take my yarn needle, go underneath the X shape and through the loop, and then slowly feed that through so that way it'll tie the knot where I want it to tie the knot, and not, it won't tie like further up on the string, creating a bunch of slack right there. And that is a tie off. And then if you want, you can take your yarn needle and weave in this tail amongst the inside of the work where you cannot see it, or it won't be as visible seen. And I go one direction, and I'll even go like between a thread just for the fibers to cling to each other and not have it be so much of a under and over kind of deal. So I'll go one direction, and then I will go backwards. And this is how my weave seems to stay the best, is when I go in both directions. Great. So come back to the beginning here. Release my yarn needle, grab my scissors, cut that tail. Perfect. And we are on to the next step. So let's go ahead and look at this bag real quick. Awesome. Looks great. All right. So the next step we are going to work on is actually creating this rope that we will weave in and out, and it'll be the part that cinches the bag closed to keep it tight around the top of the bottle. So we're down to just a little bit of yarn left, but you may think this is not enough yarn to finish off this project, but it is, I promise you. So taking your yarn and your crochet hook, starting with a long enough tail for us to weave in our ends at the end of the project, create a slip knot, attach our crochet hook. So to make that rope cinch for the bag, we will start by chaining 60 chains. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 58, 59, and 60. Great. All right, so for row one of our rope, we will look at the second chain from our crochet hook, so not including the loop on our hook. Looking at the V's, we got 1, 2, flip the chain over, and you are going to slip stitch in that middle or chain link of that stitch. So go in underneath the middle yarn there and slip stitch. And you're going to repeat this all the way down. So the next chain down, middle yarn there, and slip stitch. Make sure I am zoomed in enough for you. So if you need to look at the front to find the next V-stitch to help you or guide you, you can. Otherwise, just look at the next stitch down and slip stitch in that middle chain link. And I will meet you at the very end of this chain to show you what we do next. You're doing such a great job. Keep up the great work. All right, last two stitches of this rope part. Perfect. All right, so let's grab our scissors. Going to cut a matching length tail here. Take that tail we just cut, yarn over, pull that tail through the loop on our crochet hook, pull tight for a tie off. Perfect. And then I'm going to take these two tails and I'm going to tie a knot in them. And what this will do is it will take this from being squared off to rounding it at the end. And that's what I want. So two knots should do the trick. Right, and then it'll look like this. Perfect. Okay, so now we're going to zoom out just a little bit. What we're going to do next is grab your bottle holder, take the end of the rope that does not have the tails in it, and then find round 25, so the last round of your post stitches. And you can begin anywhere. There's no exact spot to begin, but take your end and insert it between two stitches. What's nice about the post stitches is they allow lots of room between stitches. And then skip two stitches, so 1, 2, and then weave that rope back through, just like that. And then skip two stitches, 1, 2, and insert, and then skip two stitches, 1, 2, and back through. Now, honestly, this is up to you. I skip two stitches. You could just skip one. You could skip three. You do whatever you think looks best here. I just skipped two. That's just what I did. But there's no absolute correct answer when it comes to how many stitches to skip. All right, go ahead and weave your rope all the way through, ending with give yourself a gap here from the beginning of the rope to the end of the rope of about 3 inches. You want this to be a significant opening between the two, so that way there's enough of a handle right there and it's easy to cinch. Okay, so go ahead and continue, and I'll meet you at the other end to show you what we do next. Okay. And then I actually leave a fair amount of space between the two ends of this rope, so that way you have more room to cinch it on the top. We will now take the two ends. Let me back this up a little bit. Take the two ends and grab your yarn needle or tapestry needle. Great. Weave in one of those tails. Grab the other end of your rope and you want to just join these two ends together. Now you want to wait until after you have woven that rope all the way through before you join them together. Otherwise, there's no way to weave this rope through the bag. So that's why I saved this step here. So I'm gonna go one way. Great. Just a couple times. You wanna leave enough of a tail here. Then grab the other and go ahead and do the same thing. Great. Pop. And then you want them to be popping out the same side as each other. Come on. There we go. So that way you can tie a knot to keep them secure. Great. Now don't worry about weaving these ends into the rope. We're not going to do that. These ends are not long enough. Now, if you wanted to have forethought and make those tails longer in the beginning, before doing the rope to weave them in, you could do that, but then you risk having enough yarn left over to make the tassel. And this is all we have left to work with. Okay, so we're literally using the entire skein of yarn. Grab your measuring tape or ruler. We are now onto the tassel. So for the tassel, grab your scissors. We are going to be cutting approximately 25-inch long strands. So one. And then once I have the first one, I'll use that one to guide me for like four more. So there's two. Three. Four, so that gives me, I have four right there, and come back 5 inches. So go ahead and continue cutting a total of 20 of these strips. All right, when you have cut all 20 of your strips, grab your bag. Find the rope where the join is. You're going to take all of these strips and fold them evenly over the join. We're going to hide the join with the tassel, okay? And the tails that are left over from the rope where we joined those two ends, you can just have them go in the same direction as all of the other strings of the tassel, so they just kind of blend right in. Then take what's left of your skein of yarn, which is literally like this much. We are literally using the entire skein of yarn here, which blows my mind. So grab one end, and we want to be right up against the rope here. And we are going to go around and pull it tight around. Make sure that this beginning tail is long enough for us to tie a knot in. Around and around. And you just keep going around, making it tight so it's securing it. Go. Perfect. Okay. And once you've gone as many times around as you feel comfortable, take your two ends, tie them in a knot. And then when I have my knot, I take my crochet hook, I insert my crochet hook underneath these loops, come through, grab those tails, pull those tails through, and that conceals the knot so you cannot see the knot. Everything camouflages and just cleans up the look. There's our tassel. Now to really clean it up, grab your scissors bring all of these strips to the same direction. And then cut them, and then they have this very clean look right there. And let's go ahead and zoom out. Boom. There you go. Isn't that beautiful? There's your little tassel. Here is your rope. Here is your whole festive bottle holder. And then when you pull this rope, it cinches the top of the bag and holds the top of the bottle firm. So it's super cute. I hope you have a lot of fun with this. Make lots of colors if you'd like. Personalize it to a certain individual. And I hope you had fun. All right, so what did you think of the festive bottle holder? I hope you had a lot of fun. If you want to adjust this pattern at all, it's easily adjustable. So say the bottle that you want to make this for is wider. You can absolutely make the bottom an extra round or two to expand the bottom. If you'd like help on how to do that, I'll put a link right here to show you how to add that extra row or two and what you would do. Also, if you want to make this middle section taller, or the cuff or the rope, you can adjust everything to this pattern. Just know that I used an entire skein of the super size 100% cotton lilies, sugar and cream to make this bottle holder. So if you want to make any adjustments to make this bigger, you will need an extra skein of yarn to do so. So just a little tip there. If you had fun with this project, you might also really love these projects I have right here. Check them out. Also check out this video right here, which is just a recommended video for you to watch. Thank you so much for spending time with me today, crocheting with me. I always have so much fun crocheting with you. I hope you have the best day. And I will see you with my next video. Bye, guys.